So today I'm going to talk about Linux commands and tools that will report partition table. Disk uses information, file system types, and it can also be used to modify the partition tables. So I have divided this video into two sections. In the first section, I'll talk about the commands, those who only report the information. And in the second video, I'll talk about the commands that will report the information about the drives and file system, but you can also use those commands to manipulate the partition table. So I want to give you a little bit of warning while using these commands, especially those which I will cover in the second section, because those commands deal with changing or modifying partition tables. So changing or modifying partition table, as you already know, could be a destructive process, and especially if you're not sure about the commands and what you're doing. So please be careful when using these commands, and especially before writing on the partition table. So with that warning, let's start our today's topic. And the first command that I'm gonna talk about is df. It stands for disk free. So if you simply type df, it'll print the information about your file system, available space, use space, and where the device is currently mounted on. If you use df-h, it gives you human readable form. So instead of bytes information, it'll give you in the gigabytes and the megabytes. And you can also use df with -th. So it displays the partition table with the file system types. So the second column is file system types. And if you do on this one, if you notice these file system type TMPFS, so they are temporary file systems, which keeps all its files in the virtual memory. So it's a temporary in the sense that no files will be created on the hard drive. And if you unmount the TMPFS instance, everything is stored in that mount point will be lost. So if you do then grep, you can use to print only information starting with /dev. So information about your SDA drive and the file system BTRFS, partition type and percentage and everything. So very handy tool. The second command we are going to talk about is LSBLK. So LSBLK, it lists the block devices information, but you can also use LSBLK with -f, displays the file system types, UUID and other information. So UUID is universally unique identifier for the hard drive. It's also written here on the fstab file. You can also format the output using -o option, LSBLK, if you do -o, and then you can type name, size, file system type, type of the device, and mount point. So it will just display in that format, removes all the other information. And the next command, the third command we'll talk about is BLKID. It prints the block device properties. You can simply run the command itself. And gives you the information about the partition, or you do any particular partition, then it will just display the information about that particular partition. So it also prints the same information like UUID, partition type, block size, what kind of partition it is, and partition UID. And the fourth command that I'm going to talk about is mount command. So mount command simply prints all the mount points which was mounted during the startup. And during the startup, mount command reads the information from fstab file again and decides where to mount these devices. And if you're only interested about your disk, then you can use the same grep command. And when it prints that information, you can use the help menu here, or you can also use mount-h to print the help menu, and you can see all the options available. So the fifth command that I'm going to talk about is fsck. So fsck is another important tool related to the hard disk. It checks the file system against any possible error and try to fix if possible. So you can see the manual page, and then see the exit status of the out command. If there's zero, no errors, and one means the errors were corrected. And you can use fsck with the hyphen n option. And hyphen n will display what action needs to be performed on the drive, but skips performing the actual action. Those are the five command that you can use to display the partition information. And there's one more command that you can use. It's not designed to print the file system and information, but since Linux is file-based operating system, so everything is interpreted as a file. Even your disk drive, CD-ROM, your keyboards, everything is mounted as a file. I do not have any files here, but let's create one. Now, if I do file, it says it's a cell script file. And if I just simply do it's a text file. So file command simply gives you what kind of file it is. So we can use the same command, and since Linux treats everything as a file, we can also get the information about our hard drive. So disk drives are the block devices where we can mount the file system, and the devices that connect to the serial ports, for example, keyboards or printers, those are known as character devices. So if you simply do file-sdsda2, so it gives me the information about that particular drive, which is treated as a file. So sda2, file system is btrfs, and all other information. So now let's go to the second section of the video. In the second section, I'm going to introduce to you five commands that will print you information about hard drive, but also has ability to modify the partition table. So the first command, and probably one of the most commonly used command to display your partition table, also comes in most of the Linux distribution, fdisk. fdisk-l simply prints your partition table. And if you do fdisk and give the name of the partition, you can perform the partitioning action on this particular drive. So p prints the information about that particular drive and create a new partition, and you can go through all the menu. The second command we are going to talk is cfdisk. So it's a variation of fdisk, a similar command, but it displays the menu and you can perform the action on the partition table using cursors. So it's a cursor-based program and provides a user-friendly interface. Unlike fdisk, you don't have to remember the command here. So if you do, then you can use up arrow, down arrow key to go through different partition and use the left and right arrow to select the choices. And the third command I'm going to talk about is sfdisk. So it is another variation of fdisk, and sfdisk commands, it reads and writes the partition table, but it's not interactive like fdisk or cfdisk. It reads input from the file or standard input, and that's why it's generally used for partitioning drives from scripts. So this is command driven instead of menu driven. So you can use sfdisk-d/dev/sda. Gives you the partition information. And if you do without the option, it will give you warning that says the drive is currently mounted. It's not recommended to use, but you can use hyphen F to force it. And then you can use the help command to get all the menu and stuff like that. So Q for quit, don't wanna write, no. And the fourth command that we're going to use is parted. So parted is a command to manipulate the partition of your system. You to be very careful using the command, because you can accidentally delete the partition without knowing that you have just deleted it. So be careful. P to print prints the same information like we did in fdisk. You can use help menu, and it gives you option on how to create a partition table, how to manipulate the table, and all that. But our fifth command, which I'm going to talk now, is much more versatile when it comes to dealing with partition table. And the command is gparted. So gparted is the GUI version of partition, and it's very powerful. In my third video, I talked about gparted and also showed you how to use gparted to extend the root partition of the Linux system. So I'll put a link of that video on the right top corner. Should appear in any moment now. So this is the gparted tool. You can visually see what's happening when you're performing the partition. So you can right click, you know, swap off, and then you can resize, modify, change the size space, resize, and everything. When you perform the action, if you click the right option here, it'll apply all the permission, but you can also undo that. You have done everything. And quit. So those are the tools that you can use to display the information about your disk partition, disk size, file system types, and all other information related to your partition table or your drives. So if you know any other tools or commands, let me know in the comment section. And if there's anything you would like to add on the command that I just talked about, you can also write that in the comment box. So this is it for today. Thank you for being with me on this video, and I'm hoping to see you in the next one.